Assalamualaikum, brother and sister. So today we are going to study Moss current source. Last class we have mentioned that we study four types of BJT transistor, and we have mentioned that this resistance can be converted by using active device. So if we connect base to collector, then this is equivalent to resistance. Similarly, for MOS, if you consider NMOS, this is N-type MOS. So if we connect it to gate and drain, also they act as a equivalent resistance. So now previous diagram from the BJT, now we are going to replace with this MOSFET. And most of our nowadays integrated circuit are based on CMOS. C means complementary MOSFET. So because in CMOS we have NMOS and PMOS, and they are complement to each other. And if we consider the MOS, NMOS, now we are only concentrated on NMOS only. So if you consider this configuration, then and this configuration, so we know the MOS characteristics. MOS characteristics, so this is VDS versus drain current. So this is drain current and this is VDS, and the characteristic curves, current increase with the increase of gate voltage, VGS voltage. So VGS voltage. Now if it is gate and D are connected together, then that means when VDS1 equal to VGS1, when VDS2 increase, and also this VGS2 also same, so increase. And if you consider VDS3, when VDS3, and at the same time, this is also equal to VGS3. So, and before that, current is zero. So again, we have seen that current is directly proportional to VDS. So therefore, we can consider this is equivalent to resistance, because based on Ohm's law we know that V is equal to IR and voltage or current is proportional to, so we can consider this one. Now when it operates at this condition, then there are two regions of three regions of operation. So this is known as linear region. Linear. This region is known as saturation region. Saturation region. And bottom one is known as cutoff region. So if the condition is like this, and we know for saturation, if the voltage VDS is greater or equal to VGS minus VT, then the MOSFET is in saturation. Now for this configuration, if you consider VDS greater or equal to, now VGS equal to VDS, because now D and G are connected together, minus VT. So that means this condition is always satisfied. So if the connected this way, always in saturation. Now, because now for linear region there is a current equation, also in saturation there is a current equation. Now we are only going to consider saturation current region, because transistor are in saturation. So if the transistor in saturation, in our earlier studies we know that the drain current is related to W by L, which is the width of the MOSFET and the length of the MOSFET, VG as the gate to source voltage, VT is the threshold voltage, which is defined as the voltage required to create the channel. And if there is some, if the characteristic curve is not straight, that means there is, we call is the, this is channel length, due to channel length modulation, then there is a output resistance, then we can add channel length modulation factor. So that this is the general equation. So we are going to use this equation. That means the ID in saturation current is equal to K. If it's NMOS, so that we usually write KN, or sometimes we write KN prime, W by L VGS minus VT 1 plus lambda VDS. So we need to use this equation to solve our problem. So now if you look at the MOS structure, so this is silicon dioxide, and this is a source. So this is the source, this is N plus, this is N plus. So this is silicon dioxide, and this is a substrate, which is the P sub. Now we have this is source, gate, and this is drain. So this is the this is metal. So metal oxide semiconductor. So now the length is defined for the MOSFET when L means the distance between source to drain, and the width means, so this is the, if we draw the three dimension, so this is the width of the MOSFET. Now MOSFET disk, now we have seen from that equation, drain current is directly proportional to W. So that means that if we increase the width, the MOS current is increased, and also drain current is inversely proportional to length. So that means source and drain distance increase, then electron needs more time to travel from source to drain. So therefore current also reduce, and also their or more resistance. So this is the general equation. Now we need to, last time we have mentioned the basic current source. Basic current source, and we have resistance, and we have now transistor is replaced by MOSFET, and this is VDD, this is minus VSS, and the output, this is now we have the instead of BJT we have another transistor, and we assume that this transistor is always in saturation. So now for basic current source, our these are connected. Now you are asked to design a current source. So design a current source means, so this is our reference current and this is our output current. If you consider, this is ID1 and this is ID2. If you mention design a current source, then design means in this case you need to find the value of R1, and also you need to find the value of W by L ratio of MOS1 as well as MOS2, 1 and 2, what is the ratio. So now previously in BJT design means we need to find only the value of resistance. Now in this case we need to find this value. Now if we look at this case, VGS1 and VGS2, they are equal. See, now VGS1 equal to VGS2. In this case, ID1 may or may not be equal to ID2. It depends on the W by L ratio. So now let us consider our general equation. This is ID2, output current over input current. Then we consider this equation Kn prime NMOS, W by L 1, VGS1 minus V threshold voltage VT, and this is N time MOS, this is whole square, and oh, this is 2, so suppose it is equal to 2, and this is equal to 2. Now for ID1, Kn prime, W by L 1, VGS1 minus VTN, and we neglect the channel length modulation, so we make our life little bit easier. So we assume lambda is equal to 0, that means R0 for this MOSFET is infinite. So in this case, now as I mentioned, VGS1 equal to VGS2, so now VGS2 minus VTN, VGS1 minus VTN, and transistors are same type. So these parameters are gone, half gone. Kn is known as process parameter, also they are same. Now if they are same, then ID2 divided by ID1 is equal to W by L2 divided by W by L1. So we consider ideal case, but is 0. There is no various variation. So now it shows that, so when W by 1 is equal to W by L2, that means W by L ratio for both the transistor equal, then in that case ID2 is equal to ID1. So now let us see what is ID1 and ID2. So now ID1 is actually through this one. So now ID1, so we know this gate current is 0. Now ID1 actually it is equal to reference current, because so no current is flowing through this path, and I0 equal to ID2 equal to I0. Now we have come with the relationship. So this is equal to output current divided by input current, reference current. If both I out equal to I R, if they are equal. So now this is current mirror. Or if it is more, then we can consider amplifier. Now we know how to design this ratio. Later on I'll solve some problem. So now also we need to find R1. How to find R1? In order to find R1, we need to apply as before KVL. So what is KVL states? VDD plus is equal to ID1 R1 or I reference plus VGS1 minus VSS. So therefore R1 is equal to VDD plus VSS minus VGS1 ID1. So now in this case we know this one, we know this one. If you know what is the value of VGS1, then we can solve this problem. So now let us consider some numerical example. So need to design a current source, this current source. So this current source and this current source, so that I reference I reference equal to 5 milliampere, and I not equal to 20 milliampere. So it what is given? VDD is given as 10 volt, and VSS is given 0 volt, and the transistor parameters are given. VTN is equal to 1 volt, KN prime is equal to given 60 microampere per volt square. So this is lambda also given 0. So now so these parameters are given. Also it is mentioned V22 second transistor saturation value is given, voltage VDS2 set, it is voltage 0.2 volt. Now this for transistor, this is given, and the design based on this design parameter you need to design. Then how to solve? Now first we need to find R1. R1 is equal to VDD plus VSS minus VGS1 divided by IR, because ID1 is equal to I1. So now we need to find VS1. How to find VS1? So this condition is given. VD2 set, and we know the saturation condition is equal to VGS2 minus VT. If you know this condition, then we know the VGS2 equal to VDS2 minus plus VT. So now 0.2 plus 1. So this is 1.2 volt. So now then VGS1 also 1.2 volt. Now we can substitute here. So this is 10 plus 0 minus 1.2, and this is 5 milli. So we can find the value of R1. The first part is found. Now we need to find W by L ratio for MOSFET 1 and MOSFET 2. ID1 is equal to half Kn prime W by L, or I just remove this one, KL1 VGS minus VT whole square. This is general equation. From this equation we can know W by L 2ID Kn prime VGS minus VT whole square. So now if we need to find W by L ratio, then this is 2 into 5 milli 660 micro, and this is 1.2 minus 1 whole square. So from this equation we can know what is the value of W by L. Similarly, we can find 2 into 20 milli 60 in micro 1.2 minus 1 whole square. If you look at these two equations, this is 5, this is 20. So this whole part is equal. So that means this W by L times 20 divided by 5. That means 4 times larger than W by L ratio. So this is 4 times larger. 4 times W by L1. So now we know how to solve this one. So for this particular circuit, we can may ask you to design consisting of many MOSFET or many current source. Now if you ask to design, so we can have another MOSFET, because if we do, we can easily design for different, because we need to supply, so different transistor, different biasing current. So in this case, if you consider 30 microampere, and since BGS3 gate voltage are connected all together, so BGS1 equal to VGS2 equal to VGS3. So now if it is true, then we have already calculated. Now we have calculated W by 1, and we know this is 5 milli. This is 20 milli, 5 times. this is 30 milli, 6 times. Then W by L2 is equal to 20 divided by 5 into W by L1. W by L3, this is, because they are equal, so 30 divided by 5, we can find a W by L. So now we know how to design this current source. Now if we know this current source, now because as I mentioned earlier, we don't prefer to keep the resistance in our circuit. If we don't want this resistance, then we need to replace with a MOSFET. How to replace? Copy this one and paste this one. So now we need to replace this resistance. How to replace? So in order to replace, we connect another MOSFET, because we make it resist. This is same type, same okay. So NMOS drain and resistance is connected. So VDD. So now we have M1, M2, M3 and M4. Now our problem is same. We have I reference is equal to 5 milliampere, but only difference that so now for this case our problem is the same parameters are given. So same parameters are given. So now we need to design. So already we have calculated, based on this parameter, we have already calculated VGS1 from previous equation, which is VDS2 set plus VT, which is 0.2 plus 1 is equal to 1.2, which is VGS2, also VGS3. Now, and the current flowing through M4, current flowing through a MOSFET transistor also equal to IR, reference current, same current is flowing, this current, because this current is zero. So then it is IR, because zero current continue with this, no current, so continue with this. So now, but how to find, because there is no resistance, but we need to find W by L4, which is equal to 2IR divided by KN prime VGS4 minus VT whole square. So now this case, our unknown parameter is VGS4. So now VGS4. Now how to find VGS4, brother and sister, from this diagram?
Again.
So how to solve VGS4 from VGS4? Because in order to find W by L4 ratio, we need to find VGS4. How to find? So again same
one minus V
same
minus KVL.
KVL, yes, that's right. So just again we can go through this KVL. So if we write the KVL, then we can write VDD equal to VGS4 plus VGS1 plus minus VSS. So for this case, VGS4 equal to VDD plus VSS minus VGS1. So now we know this value we already found. So from this calculation, we solve. Right. So now I can write VGS4 equal to VDD plus VSS minus VGS1. So then after then we can substitute, then we know what is the ratio between W by L for the same transistor. Because now the gate voltages are different. So now I extend this problem to another. So copy. So now this problem, so little bit different, so I just copy this one and the problem mentioned. So this is shifted a little bit. So only difference is that in this case I don't mention this one. Instead of mentioning this one, I have mentioned M1, M4 and M5 are identical. So instead of given saturation voltage, I have mentioned this condition. If I mention this condition, then you need to find the ratio of all the transistor, W by L ratio for 5 transistor to 5. Then how to solve? Now if you write the KVL, then it is mentioned VDD plus equal to VGS4 plus VGS3 plus this is 4 plus VGS1 minus VSS, or we can write VGS4 plus this is VGS4 plus VGS1 equal to VDD plus VSS. And what is our condition? Our condition is all transistors are identical. These three transistors are identical. Identical, and their gate and drain are connected. If they are connected together, so that means they are representing equivalent to resistance. That means now we have this transistor, we can consider R5, this is R4, and this is R1. So this is VGS1 and this is VGS2 and this is VGS4. Since now this is R, this is R, this is R, because identical means identical resistance. If their resistance are equal, then the voltage also equal. So what we can do, we can write VGS, 3 VGS equal to VDD plus VSS. So therefore we found VGS1 is equal to VDD plus VSS divided by 3. So now in previous problem we found VGS based on VDS value. In this case we are calculating based on identical. If there are 4-5 transistors identical connected, then we need to divide by this factor. Correct. For example, in 2 transistor case, these 2 transistor case, for example, these 2 transistor case, 2 transistor case, base. So we ask the problem. So instead of VDT set, we mention VM1 and let me see, and M4 are identical. So instead of VD2 set, so we mention, then in this case what is this? The VDD plus VSS is equal to VGS4 plus VGS1. So identical, so then we can write 2 VGS1. Therefore VGS1 is equal to VDD plus VS divided by 2. So now because we change our problem, instead of VD2 set, we have mentioned M1 and M42 are identical because there are 2 transistors, so therefore we divide by 2. Now can you draw the equivalent circuit diagram for this transistor, this configuration? Can or cannot?
It's equivalent, sir.
Small signal equivalent circuit. For example, if I ask you to draw the small signal equivalent circuit, for example, this one. So this one, okay, I'll draw. And probably if I draw, then you can recall everything. Minus VSS, and this is VDD. So this is M1, M2, M3. And this is output current. This is reference current. Now if I ask you to draw this small signal, what we can do, I just keep this diagram. So then we know, then gate 2, so this is ground, and this ground, because DC ground, and gate 2 source, there is no resistance, but there is a current source, which is GM1 VGS1 parallel to output resistance, and this is connected. So after this is, now we connect. So after drawing this one, just we remove this one. So this also we cannot remove this one. So second transistor, we have gate, and this no, this is source for second transistor. This is gate, no resistance, but there is a current source with output resistance 0, 3, 1, and this is GM3 VGS3, and this is connected. So after this is connected, after drawing, so we need to remove this. So in this case, so again gate 2 source, there is no resistance. If it is BJT, then we have one resistance. This is drain, we have again current source and output resistance R0 to GM2 VGS2. So then this is output current. So after that, so we remove. So this is the equivalent circuit. For example, if you use, you can flip this one to make it ground. So make it to bottom. It is okay. So now this is the current, small signal current source. Now similarly, we can draw all complex network also. So this is the end, because we don't study, end of chapter 10. So is any question, brother and sister?
No question for now.
So now in the current source, we have studied BJT for configuration. So one is basic, modified Wilder and Wilson current source. Wilson. But MOSFET, although in the basic transistor we can replace the upper resistance with BJT also, MOSFET we study only basic configuration. Now before ending, so just I from the slide, I just bring some info why we need MOS copy. So what is mentioned? MOSFET current. MOSFET current source are analogous to BJT current source. We can convert a BJT current source to an equivalent MOSFET current source by assuming that beta of BJT is finite. Since MOSFET do not draw any gate current, there is no need for base current compensation as they are with BJTs, although we have not studied those compensation. The choice of BJT source or a MOSFET source generally depends on type of integrated circuit involved, that is bipolar. So bipolar circuit we use BJT and MOS, which is nowadays most of the circuit are MOS or CMOS. BJT source have some advantages over MOSFET source, such as wider compliance range and higher output resistance. However, higher output resistance can be obtained by cascode like connection of MOSFET. So also MOSFET also MOS it occupied less area and also consume less power compared to BJT. So this is more this. So any other question, brother sister, before we stop our class? From next and onward class, Professor Mutakabbir will continue with two chapters. One is feedback, another is oscillator. Oscillator. So this is chapter 12 and this is chapter 15. Also time to time you can communicate through classroom. So if you have any problem, if you don't understand, then I can come to, you can ask me, or I can come again through this online environment. You just inform me, I'll be there. What time you are prefer, then I'll be available during that time. So if any consultation, you can message in the classroom, say, sir, I need this topic to understand, I need to meet you. You mention the time so that I can, if I have, I see that time is suitable for me, then I can mention okay. Or if not suitable, then I can give you another suitable time. Anything?
Anything, sir.
So, brother Wan Hadi, anything? Sleeping, probably. Sister Nadia Tul, okay. Brother Moaz?
Yes, I'm okay, sir.
Okay. So, Amir Ashraf?
Sir, for Prof. Mutakabbir, sir, class, what time, sir?
So, this time, yesterday I talked to him, he mentioned he has no problem. So, follow
no problem.
That.
Same time.
Because he has mentioned problem with the 2 o'clock class, not your class.
Okay,
no problem. So later on, if he can decide, then later on you can discuss with Dr. Mutakabbir if he need to change his class schedule.
All right, thank you, sir.
Welcome. Anything?
No, sir.
So if not, then I can conclude today's class by recitation of Surah Al-Asr. Okay, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.